Sikhism. Guru Nanak. There is one God. He is the Supreme Truth. He, the Creator, is without fear and without hate. He, the Omnipresent, pervades the universe. He is not born, nor does he die to be born again. By his grace shalt thou worship him. Before time itself there was truth. When time began to run its course, he was the truth. Even now, he is the truth, and evermore shall truth prevail. All are subject to his will, and none is exempt from it, Nanak. If man were to understand Lord's will, then no one would take. There are millions of worlds below and above ours. Man's mind is tired of this great search. It cannot reach the end of his vastness. How can the infinite be reduced to the finite? All attempts to describe him are futile. He alone knows how great he is. None knoweth the Lord's beginnings, nor his end. Avoid such food which cause pain to the body and arouse passion in the mind. Avoid such dresses which cause pain in body and arouse passion in the mind. Wealth, youth, and flowers are so short-lived as the leaves of water lily. They wither, fade, and finally die away. He alone is learned and educated who gains self-knowledge through self-enlightenment. If we serve humanity in this world, then we would be welcomed in the court of God. No man shall coerce another. No man shall exploit another. Everyone, each individual, has an inalienable birthright to seek and pursue happiness and self-fulfillment. Love and persuasion is the only law of social coherence and harmony. Having created the universe, the Lord abides therein. He who avails of the lifetime is really the servant of God. There is only one air, earth, and only one light of the God in each being. Cruelty, worldly love, avarice, and wrath are the four streams of fire. By falling into them, the mortal is burnt, O Nanak. Emancipation is obtained by clinging to a living of truthfulness. Nanak, without the Guru, there is no spiritual honor, and without this honor, one cannot ferry across the worldly ocean. If one goes on living the life of indignity, such life is not worth living. For such a life, all eating is eating in shame. The evildoer is a demon who knows not the master. He is a madcap who understands not his own self. Make wisdom thy mother, contentment thy father, and truthfulness thy brother. These are thine good relations. He who restrains his mercurial mind slays restraints his five evil passions. When man abandons desire, then alone does he become a true renouncer. The mind is greedy king and is enamored of avarice. Under guru's instruction, greed is removed and man arrives at an understanding with God. You are the embodiment of light. O man, recognize thy essence. Divine knowledge is not acquired by mere words. To describe it is hard like iron. If one becomes the recipient of Lord's grace, then alone he obtains it. Other contrivances and orders are but ruinous. If thou desirest thy good, O man, perform virtuous deeds and be humble. The sinner, like the deer hunter, bows twice as much. What can be achieved by bowing the head when a man goes with a filthy mind? Says Nanak, meditate thou on true Lord. If thou art pure, then alone shalt thou obtain the true one. Of women are we born, of women conceived, to women betrothed and wedded. Women we befriend. By her continues the human race. When woman dies, woman is sought, for it is she who maintains world order. Why revile her of whom are born the great? Of woman is born another woman. None exists without her. The eternal God, says Nanak, is the only one not born of her. Render thou such service as may bring thee some profit. You live your life making earnest efforts and make your life happy through rightful earnings. Meet the Lord through contemplation, and your anxieties will be dispelled. Nanak, as many are the vices, so many are the chains round the neck. Yea, one removes the vices with the cultivation of virtues in life, as virtues are our only friends. We are men of but one breath, and know not the appointed time and moment of our departure from this world. We treat everybody as our friend, and all are our associates. Efface thine own self, ego. Then shalt thou obtain the groom, God. What another cleverness can avail? Chastity, contentment, and truthfulness I ever gather in my lap, and my God loves me for my truthfulness. The blind fools are without wisdom, and blind is their understanding. Nanak, they who are bereft of the Lord's grace obtain not honor ever. A saint is better off without bathing. A thief is always a thief, whether he bathes in sacred waters or not. If he who plays the tyrant is honored, then deem it to be the surest sign of the dark age. When the mind is not pure, what is the good of practicing outward cleanliness? Everyone say that the Lord is one, but each one is engrossed in ego and pride. He alone is a wise man who gains spiritual knowledge through meditation upon the divine virtues. The glories are in the Lord's own hand. He blesses those with whom He is pleased. For the sake of wealth, the mortals become servants and thieves, but it goes not with them and remains behind for another. The word, Shabbat, is the guru, and the mind attuned to the Shabbat is the disciple. The Shabbat is the guru, teacher, fathomless, and calm. Without the Shabbat, the people wander astray. Attune your mind to the world, guru. Falsehood shall come to an end, O Nanak, and truth shall ultimately prevail. Foolish and unwise are they who seek to rule over others, for the only one who is true is God. O praise be to the Lord. He alone, O Nanak, knows the right path of life, who earns his livelihood with the sweat of his brow and shares it with his fellow human beings. He who indulgeth in pleasures here is in pain hereafter. Saith Nanak, no one is emancipated without the true name. I have forgotten to speak ill or think ill of anyone ever since I learnt to live in the company of good and holy saints. No one is my enemy, nor anyone stranger to me. I get on well with one and all. Man is carved in the image of God. The drop is contained in the ocean. The ocean in the drop. The merit of routine deeds and ritualistic religion, acts of piety and self-control and pilgrimages, austerities and meditations are contained in the Guru's word. The body is the temple of God, in which are revealed precious pearls of knowledge. The Lord first created the light. From the Lord's play, all living creatures came. And from the divine light, the whole creation sprang. Why then should we divide humans into high and low creatures? Brother, be not in error. Out of the Creator, the creation comes. Everywhere in the creation, the Creator is. The Lord's Spirit is all-pervading. The Lord, the Maker, has molded one mass of clay into vessels of diverse shapes. Free from taint are all the vessels of clay, since free from taint is the divine potter. Recognize all mankind, whether Hindu or Muslims, as one. The same Lord is the creator and nourisher of all. Recognize no distinction among them. The monastery and the mosque are the same. So are the Hindu worship and the Muslim prayer. Men are all one. In this life, our actions are the ink and mind the paper. We inscribe on it the two writings of good and evil. Neither do I call myself good, nor I see anyone bad. The fool indulges in sensual pleasures, which in the end lead to pain. Easy and sinful life is the cause of diseases. Truth is the highest of all virtues, but higher than truth is true conduct. Man concealeth all the sins he committeth, but at last they are all disclosed. More than all else do I cherish at heart that love which makes me to live a limitless life in this world. Man's sins are the work of his heart. What happiness is there without virtue? Human life is lost without virtue.